Okay, so good morning dear students. So we have started chapter number 7, the equatorial regions, and this is the 6th or I think almost up to from page number 43 that we have completed people and the culture. And last time we have discussed the official language of the country DRC, Democratic Republic of the Congo, is French. But the military people, military, those who are in military, they are speaking the language Lingala. The official language of the military is Lingala. So don't be confused. And afterwards we have started the economy. So the country deposit very much minerals and leading producer of industrial diamonds. It also produces about half of the world's cobalt. Okay, we discuss yesterday. Okay, and other minerals are copper, gold, silver, zinc, manganese, tin, germanium, uranium, radium, iron ore, coal, and bauxite. So these are the various minerals are found from the country DRC, and I hope that you have underlined it very well. So once again, from then we are continue and. Last time, the mining activities, some of the pictures that I have shown you through the screen sharing. Mining activity. Mining means, and I have given the example of KGF. If you have watched that movie, okay, watch that movie, you will understand how the workers, slavery going on in the different mining sites. So most of the people doing mining, doing work in the different coal mine, gold mine, silver mine, different minerals mines are available in the Democratic Republic of Congo. So mining is the main economic activity which is doing by the citizen of Democratic Republic of the Congo. So other industries, which are the other industries are flourish in this country? So apart from them, cement, paper, chemical, petroleum, and soap and textile industries are flourish in this country. Okay, now, so water is an abundance here. Now have a look on page number 43. From that onwards, we are going to start. Okay. I hope that you are able to understand what we are discussing right now. Okay. So water that you will get abundance in very big amount that you will get in this country. Electricity is produced from the Congo River and it is also exported to other countries. Electricity, they are producing electricity. They are generating electricity, my dear students, from this water. From the Congo River basin, and they are exporting this electricity which is generated in this country. Okay, they are exporting to another countries, neighboring countries. In the past, the European exploited the natural resources of the country for their own benefits. European, same way, the British are, okay, exploited the Indian culture, the Indian farms, the Indian treasures, everything has had been exploited by the Britishers during the year from 16th to 19th century. In the same way, European countries attacked on this DRC, Democratic Republic of Congo, and exploit, humiliate everything from this country. They have stolen. So what they have done? Keeping it under foreign rule for many years, in 1960, the country became independent, but still people have been unable to fully utilize their vast mineral resources. The country got freedom in the year of 1960, underline. Okay, in the year, become independent. Here, you have to do underline. 1960. Okay, just underline it here. Thus, we were, they are not able, the public, same way in India after the independence of the Indian people, not able to utilize how to do, what to do, when to do. They were totally in great catastrophic situation. Same way, after the independence, they are not able to utilize their mineral, how to use that minerals, they don't know. Okay. So industries are not well developed and are based on agriculture raw materials. Most of the minerals are exported. Minerals are available in that country, but the proper industries were not there present to do proper work, to use, to utilize these minerals. And that is why minerals were there, but now they turn to agriculture. They depend on the agriculture activity for the different, to collect different raw materials. Okay. So most of the minerals are exported. So whatever from the different mines, they are going to collect. So they are exporting. Okay. They are exporting from other countries. Okay. Now, occupation. I'm going to share the screen. Just wait for one or half second, you will get. Okay. The occupation. Occupation that I am going to discuss now. It will soon on your screen. Occupation of Democratic Republic of the Congo. Occupation, major occupations. Okay. That I am going to show you very soon on your screen, it will be there. Okay. Now I am going to show you. I am going to share the screen right now on your screen. Major occupation of the Democratic Republic of the Congo. I hope that on your screen you are able to see. Okay. Okay, major occupations. Here on your screen, Democratic Republic of the Congo. Some of the pictures are there. So from them you are able to understand what the occupation they are doing for their living. Okay. So occupation, now turn to page number 44. Okay. Farming is the major occupation. On your screen, you can see how the people of this country, in the same way, we are also engaged in India, the agriculture activity. In the same way, on your screen right now, you are able to see they are engaged in the farming. Farming, major occupation of this country. Large area of forest have been cleared for the farming. Large area they have cut down. Okay, here, how they cut down the major areas of the forest to do the farming activity. Okay, here also how they cut down, you can see it. Okay, they cut down to do the activity, farming activity. Okay, so just underline the which is the major occupation of this country, underline, and the major occupation of the country is farming. Okay, underline it on page number 44. On page number 44. Okay, the chief crops cultivated are rice, maize, and cassava. Underline, which are the major crops are cultivating in DRC? So, major crops cultivated are rice, maize, and cassava. that is new for you. Okay, let me show you some of the pictures. Cassava root. Okay, cassava root. I am going to show you the pictures, so you will better understand. The images will be there soon. See, cassava. Okay, see, cassava root. These are the pictures. It is there, yes or no, in India? Cassava. Like that only. On Shivratri that we are eating. Such kind of root. Okay, see, cassava root, it is there. Some of the pictures that I am going to show you on your screen right now. I hope that you are able to see. Show me the thumb if you are able to see the cassava root. Very good. See the cassava roots. The root that is dried and pounded into flour, which is used to make bread. So this, okay, we are using right now wheat to make bread. And they are using this cassava root to make the bread. Okay. Pounded into flour, which is used to make bread. Varieties of cash crops such as cocoa, coffee. Okay. Cocoa, coffee, tobacco, cotton, rubber and oil palm are also grown by the farmers and are exported to the other countries. They are also exporting this kind of vegetables. Then crops like tobacco, cotton, rubber, cocoa, coffee. Cocoa, have you ever seen it? Cassava root, it is here. I am going to show you now. The cocoa, okay? Cocoa, which is produced. Now it will be there on your screen soon. Cocoa. See, some of the pics are here. Cocoa seeds. How good it is on your screen. I hope that you are able to see the cocoa. Now I am going to show you the coffee now. Cocoa, then coffee. Okay. Coffee seeds. Coffee plants. See, coffee seeds are there. On your screen, thousands of times, different pictures of coffees. Coffee seeds are there, you can see. Okay. Here, you can see coffee seeds. Both are looking similar, cocoa and coffee. Okay. Then, tobacco, that you are very used to of it. You, okay, tobacco farms are there in our Charodar area, in Petlad, Borsan, Aklao, Anand, Nadiyad, everywhere. You are able to see. Then, cotton, I am going to show you. Cotton. Okay, cotton. It will be there on your screen. See, cotton. The cotton cultivation is going on in our area, most of in the South Gujarat, in Bharuch side. Bharuch and place for Ratpardi. Okay, cotton crops, they are cultivating. So this kind of different types of, okay, see. Different pictures on your screen right now. Cotton. Beautiful pictures of the cotton here on your screen right now. Okay, then rubber and oil palm. Rubber that you have seen, now oil palm. Oil palm, okay. See, on your screen it will be there. See, oil palm. The cultivation, the different plants of oil palm, it is there. on your screen right now. I hope that you are able to see it properly. See how good it is looking, oil palm. And they are exporting in the other countries. Exporting, they are sending in other countries. Okay, so such kind of occupation, thus such kind of farming which is done. Let me show you one more pictures so we will better understand. See, see, this is the palm oil. See on the screen right now you have. This is the farm of palm oil. Okay, they are doing this activity. I hope that you are getting what we are discussing right now. Okay, the last topic it is there that we are going to discuss tomorrow onwards. Okay, tomorrow onwards that we are going to discuss. Okay, I hope that we are able to understand what we have discussed here. Okay, varieties of cash crops. Now activity is there, cassava plant and fishing in Congo. You have to do underline here. Cash crops such as cocoa, they can easily earn money in short period of time. Okay, cocoa, coffee, just underline, tobacco, cotton, rubber, then palm, oil palm. Okay, also grown by the farmers and exported in other countries. Underline it for one mark, very important question. Okay, see and underline very well and show me afterwards. So you, whether I know that you are doing or not. Okay. Okay. So cassava is a root that is dried and pounded into flour, which is used to make bread. Then variety of cash crop. Cash crop means they can easily earn money, profit, get proper profit from short period of time by cultivating such kind of crops like rubber, cotton, tobacco, cocoa, coffee, oil palm. And farmers, they are exporting these cash crops in other countries, neighboring countries. Okay, that's up to here that we are concluding here. I hope that you are understood about the occupation, about the economy of this Democratic Republic of the Congo. Yes or no? Very good. Okay, so dear students, I hope that you have understood well.